Old Trafford. Third place, Wimbledon, don't have a ground. This is where it's masterminded. Playing fields at Roehampton in southwest London, owned by the council.
Joe Kinnear has had to watch his teams be broken up and sold, but the Dublin-born boss isn't bitter. It comes with the office.
And I've been a good judge up to now of the players that I've bought. I've been always trying to keep one step ahead of the posse, as they say. I know that I've got players here that are still well sort of, because I know top Premier League managers ring me on a regular basis and inquire about my players. So therefore, when the time comes that I have to lose one of these players, I want to make sure that I've got somebody bedded in.
Well, we run it like any family would run their own affairs, prudently. We follow the normal home economics, and we don't spend what we don't have. It's as simple as that.
The biggest burden is not getting big enough gates to keep our best players. And that's a tragedy in many respects, because all those players I've worked with, and I know the capabilities of all those, I know if they were here, we would be knocking on the door of the Premier League Championship, no question about that.
Their battling qualities might have got them into trouble, and they may be dubbed the Crazy Gang, but few can deny there's method in their madness. They've twice won this season with 10 men. It's their best start in 9 years.
Joe Kinnear is a very special manager. He's proved that he can buy wisely. He proved that he has very deep tactical awareness. He's a first-class motivator, and in short, he's a hell of a manager.
The gaffer joins in as a crack with the boys. He's one of the boys. He loves joining in the games and that. And when we're actually on the training pitch, we train very, very hard, you know, and the gaffer plans it all, you know, how he wants us to play against them. He watches all the videos, you know, so we don't just put a kit on and go out and play against teams, you know. There's a lot of, hell of a lot of work goes in.
The club's greatest moment was their FA Cup final victory over Liverpool in 1988. Bobby Gould masterminded their against the odds triumph, and his memento of the day has pride of place among his football trophies. He says the spirit at the club now goes beyond just an inner belief in themselves.
They are now learning to adapt. Joe has become a very good technical awareness of understanding what the game's all about. They can go from playing a sweeper system to a flat back four and to playing three players up front. And they can adapt very, very easily. And that is the sign of any good side. Sometimes the off-the-field incidents overtake, and this has got to be a major problem for Joe Kinnear and Sam Amman, because that takes your strength away from you. Instead of just concentrating on the football, it then becomes incidental, and you have to go off on another tangent. And if they can control that and put everything into the right context, they can really, really be a threat.
It's up to other teams to come and beat us, and if we have to put our foot in, then so what? That's part and parcel of the game, as long as it's done fairly. The other stuff, the pushing and shoving fight, and I'm not particularly in love with that myself. But sometimes we're harshly treated.
Wimbledon go to Villa Park this weekend, where last season they were completely taken apart. Having been 1-0 up, they slumped to an embarrassing 7-1 defeat.
They murdered us up there last year, absolutely murdered us. We're going up now in a confident mood with the settled side, and I assure you the result will be very, very difficult.
Everyone talks about football being big business, and football is a business. Football is never a business. Football is a love affair.